you follow will determine what? Let me explain that to you. Right in this place are different people. Whether you believe it or not, we are controlled by foundations and altars.
Yes.
And so, if you are moving or following a man who has wrong foundation or wrong altar, as that altar is speaking into that man's life, by association, it's affecting you. I know some of you, you know how to keep it. It's very good, it's very good. But if you want to go far in life, prayerfully choose who you follow. That was what Anna did. Prayerfully choose who you follow. Your destiny will be limited, or it will be enhanced by the people you follow. Are you hearing me? Your destiny will either be limited or it will be enhanced, supported, helped by the people you follow. So, those you are following, the friends that surround you, do you know the altar that is speaking over their life? This is destiny. You miss it once, you miss it forever. There is no, I know some of you watch that movie, Consequences. It's only in movie. Are you hearing me? A man who has a destiny and you missed it, except that by the mercies of God. Two, 3 weeks ago, a pastor was buried. After pastoring for over 20 years, the enemy took his life at his own will. Child of God should not be scared of death. But when the enemy determines how you die, it's an error. Are you hearing me? They shut down the ministry. They drove him outside, no roof over his head. And he asked family members who are abroad, not one of them remembered him. Life is warfare. If you play with your prayer life, you play with your destiny. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
They shut his ministry, drove him outside. Then they made sure that his helpers, his own blood, they refused to remember him. And they took his life. He was buried 3 weeks ago. Hello?
Hi.
Now that he has been, they want to bury him. His brothers that I now brought, they all came. Dropping one million. When he was alive, do you know what 1 million would do for him? People don't just end by mistake. It is something that compares. Also, those who forget you, if you like, be angry with them, you are wasting your energy. It is something on your life that is making them to forget you. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
I have an uncle right in this place. I was in Port Harcourt. One of our sons in ministry, Dr. Harry, met me there. He brought his wife, telling his wife how God saved his life by attaching himself to me. Poverty destroyed him. And he said the only language I was telling him, pray. So as I was praying, he followed me and prayed his way out of the limitation that seized an entire family. Today he's a medical doctor in Port Harcourt. When he took me to his house, I thought I was in the UK. I said, is this the Port Harcourt? They said, yes, sir. Husband and wife, brand new car. In this Nigeria, brand new car. Not good to get. She told the wife, where he was before God connected him to me. If it, he was not the only person, some of them, no, some of them say, everything I pray, pray. Foundation, everything I pray, are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Everything I pray. Mostly for those of us, that foundation, our evil foundation is fighting us. If you not pray, they're going to kill you. I heard that there are pastors going around and preaching all kinds of things. Excessive grace message. Destroying the foundation that our fathers had laid and handed over to us. That there's no need to pray, there's no need to fast. And these people, they can say that because they don't get evil foundation with the word. Me and you, if you stop praying, evil foundation will finish you. Not join them, let them be preaching the essential grace message. The same message that our fathers, their devils, have been preaching, and God has delivered them. Follow no road so that you will not die before your time. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Wrong company. If Dr. Erin did not attach himself, they were living in Abengero, the sample, seven of them in one room. Yet, his uncle was the second in command in Air Force in Nigeria. You think attack is not real? Be joking. You think life is joke? The man is second in command, yet, he could not remember that God. Deliver me from wrong company. Deliver me from wrong company. A man who is living in Air Force Estate in Port Harcourt, well planned, with 247 security. You know we prayed for. I thought we wanted to pray for 30 minutes. Before we would pray for 2 hours. Why prayer not go sweet without the environment? Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
We prayed for 2 hours and the glory fell. You know why? Right company. Right company. Are you hearing me? Stop following people that have foundation worrying them. Following people who cannot pray for 1 hour. Even you, can you pray for 1 hour? You look me. You can't pray for 1 hour. Foundation will deliver. God delivered from foundation today. Yeah, are you hearing me? How old are you, bros? 13. I was 14 when I had the encounter with Jesus. 14. Are you 14 years? How old are you, 14? 14. When I did what Anna did, locked myself from friends. And I see people say they are young. At 14, 15, I could pray for 3 to 7 hours. Fast for 7 to 14 days. Why? I was connected to the wrong. You see, our father that came to us, the wrong. I was connected to the right company. Are you hearing me? Age is a number. Hey, parents that are here, don't tell your children they are young. You are the one that will suffer it too. This is what Buhari has done this country to. You want to join Buhari? Say they are young. Our boy is 5 years old. At 3 years, he has started praying. For Mark, you didn't hear me, so you didn't preach another message. No, you don't start to. Me and you will go, we are not twice like you. Don't be soon again, though.
Amen.
Don't say they are too young. At 3 years old, he has started praying. Some of you have called and you've heard him pray. You've heard my boy pray, Ebenezer. At 5, we're begging him, Ebenezer, pray. The prayer is too long. At 5, the prayer is too long. He called the grandfather. We finished speaking. He said, Granddad, can I pray for you? At 5 years old, my dad was almost crying. Now they are young. It's the time to treat them. It's the time to treat them. Are you hearing me? If I told myself, I'm just 14, I'm just 15, I would have been in an urban area, catching fish, open jam, drinking kai kai. But I hear me so, your destiny is important. One more time, deliver me from wrong company. Do you love yourself? Pray that prayer. Deliver me from wrong company. Deliver me from wrong company. I still have to minister in Abo. Go to Lagos, no further information. For those of you, some people try to reach me, I did not pick any call. Immediately, I reached out to my wife. She gave me a concept. I started. It's as if Satan knew why God was sending me to Lagos. The vehicle I entered in Asawa did not leave Asawa before it broke down. We are talking about even foundation. Tomorrow, get ready to pray. For those of you who have things, that is how we are here. This is not true. We are here practically. If you are ready to pray, we pray together. You are waiting for somebody to come and pray for you. We don't do that. We will pray with you. You will use your mouth to pray. When I saw the demonic resistance on the way for me not to get to Lagos, I shut my phone off. Satan began to speak. If you go, you will die. If you go, you will die. I didn't find the Lord. I didn't answer him either. I said, God said, go to Lagos. Lagos is where we go. My family house is in Lagos. I was close to the gate when I called my stepmom, called my younger sister. I am in the family house. You see, you didn't tell us, I don't need to tell you. If I tell you, what will you do? Will you pay my flight ticket? Everybody out. Father Joshua was with us. Emergency family deliverance. God said, don't enter the house, stay outside. We prayed till about 12 in the midnight. Hello? Hello? Some of you, you don't want to pay sacrifice for your own destiny. Things are going scatter. You don't want to decide to say, God, this thing cannot continue. To and fro 16 hours because there was no flight to book. They said, shut up. So you enter the road. Why? God said, go to Lagos. On my way to Lagos, God began to show me why he was sending me to Lagos. I said, no wonder Satan is fighting. When we began to pray, my stepmom was like this. God was taking things that has been done decades that nobody was aware of. You think this happened to you because they don't want to happen. They don't want to help me. Something is making them not to want to help you. Stop being angry with people. Deal with your own foundation. Are you hearing me? Woman of God. Deal with your own foundation. 2 hours. As we are declaring, heaven was here. A couple of those lead us. As God was speaking, they were confirming it. Hello. I went on Wednesday, but on Thursday I was already in Accra. You think it was easy? Eh? We call people now. Easy. Okay. Carry your kettle, but what is your kettle? Do on my own. Evil foundation. Okay, maybe some for purpose of reference. My dad is in the ex-military. He served in Niger military for 30 years. He was sent abroad for training and to gather intelligence all over the world. Now, by the degree of his qualification, he would have retired a general, a man who served side by side with Olusegun Obasanjo, side by side. They fought side by side. The highest rank he got to was a captain. He stayed there for 20 years because he retired. You think he's not married? What is the essence of traveling the world to study? If it's only captain. Are there not people who might see result and become a captain? I have met one. He said, God punish foundation.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? When you are coming tomorrow, come to pray. 20 years as a captain. What happened to promotion? Everybody say foundation, 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 foundation.
Foundation.
Foundation. He got to the UK. They said stay. He said no. He's going home. He's going home. He went home as a captain. He remained a captain. What is that? Foundation. He came to a place. Foundation is wicked. If you don't deal with your foundation, when you get to the end of your life, you will regret. Because the suffer you would have suffered. You will only live to be blaming people. Are there not people who are blaming people? They say, they refuse to help me. They refuse to help me. I look at them. I say this one. When foundation finish with you, you will know that every apology. Be blaming people. Don't deal with your foundation. When we are praying all night, why do you think we are praying all night? You think we don't know how to sleep? If we cannot sleep, can't we take sleeping tablet? When we are praying all night, you are sleeping. Let me look for people to blame. Every evil foundation, we'll deal with it tomorrow. Every evil foundation speaking against my destiny, because I am here tonight, Father, destroy it in my life. This prayer is a prayer you pray aggressively. Any evil foundation speaking against my destiny, Father, destroy it.
Be the strong.
There are five of you, the Lord wants me to touch you. I don't know who you are. But as I touch you, the hand of God will touch you. Please, if you can come inside, come inside. Now, this last prayer point, you will pray with all of your heart. They have talked to your father. They have talked to your mother. Will you close your mouth so that they stop you?
No.
Marriages in your family. Will you close your mouth so that they destroy your own marriage?
No!
This last one. You will pray with all your heart. Five of you, the hand of God will touch you. You will pray with all your heart. What stopped my mother will not stop me. What stopped my father will not stop me. Now when you are praying, you will close your eyes. You pray and pray. Forget who is by you. If God is touching somebody, forget that person. Focus on your God yourself. And if not time to look for, you will look for Jesus. What stopped my father will not stop me. What destroyed marriages in my heart will not destroy me. What destroyed destinies will not destroy me. Open your mouth right now.
I'm gonna go get some more.
Thank you.